Hello, good people. I am Tamika Maribel King. Y'all may call me Tika Talks. So listen, what is, chemistry? Chemistry. Let's talk about chemistry in your marriage. Sometimes people are neglectful of their spouse. If you have forgotten what it felt like when you first got together because you've been together a long time and, you just think to yourself, I don't necessarily need or feel the need or want, to be up on him or her and do what we used to do. We're older. We can't. Things may not work as well. Whatever the case, we're going to need to stop. I think affection is so big and having a connection is so much bigger. You know, me and my husband spend a whole lot of time communicating, a whole lot of time talking every single day throughout the day, and I know some people may be in a place where they're not able to speak to their spouse all day long or throughout the day or however it may be. But if you are, and even if you are not, when they do come home at night, what are you doing when they come home at night? Like, how are y'all connecting? Do you just go into separate rooms? Do you do separate things? Do you only do things with the children? We need to love on them, each other. You know what I'm saying? Instead of thinking that, oh, okay, he's just going to be here. She's just going to be here. Everybody has needs. And truly, you feel a whole lot better when the needs are met. Versus going weeks without having sexual intercourse. I've talked to people and they be like, oh, I don't even need it. Why not? Okay. I know that your spouse did not get what you thinking you were not going to be active sexually. So why would you want to refrain from sex unless it is a medical condition that causes you to be unable to perform or have sex? Y'all got to be real with y'all selves. Y'all got to be real with the people you're with. You need to be connected. You need to communicate. You need to have affection going on. Y'all need to date. Y'all need to go out. Y'all need to love on each other. Y'all need to have quiet time. Y'all need to have quality time. Y'all need to continuously get to know one another, because as time progresses, we all grow, or we should be growing. And if you're growing, then they may not, they need to stay up to speed with what's going on with you, with the way you are maturing, with the way you are changing, with the way you grow spiritually. All those things are vital in the relationship. So, if you want it to work, you can't be saying or not saying the things that need to be said in your relationship. Honestly, love who you're with. And if you don't love them, then perhaps you're not supposed to be there. But in my marriage, I'm not perfect. My husband is not either. But we have awesome chemistry. We connect very well. And I attribute that to God being the core, number one. And then secondly, our ability to constantly communicate and share what we're feeling. And nobody acting crazy. We don't trip on each other over, baby, I wish you would do this more. Or I wish you would, okay, now that you mention it, because I want him to feel loved. I want him to feel wanted, because he is, and in the same way, I desire the same, and he makes me feel that way. So that's big. And if you are expecting your marriages to work, you cannot expect only one person to try and do all the work. You are a team. You are one. So do it together. Literally. Stop trying to act like, oh, well, I'm mad he did this or he did that. I'm not, the likeliness is the man is not trying to withhold anything, but you got to do better as a woman and not try and use that as your tactic to get what you want or to change him or the situation. It doesn't work. You know what I'm saying? If you want to change it, then connect with him, because they're physical. Men are so physical, you know, and we are mental. So, you know, our sexual nature starts in the mind, whereas theirs is just with their eyes. What they see is, you know, okay, you know, come on, girl. For us, you know, it's a little more, you want to talk, you may want to have foreplay, which you might not be able to do every single time. But, you know, when we constantly communicate throughout the day and we're conversing about different things, oh, sometimes that is some foreplay, okay? Spice it up. Do something different with yourselves. Do something different with each other. But whatever it is, don't let the fire go out. Don't let the fire go out and somebody else try to light a fire in with your mate. And, you know, I'm not saying that's right or that, you know, people should do that to each other. But it is a reality that when you are missing what you need, and it is a need, whether people want to say that or not, you know, whether you want to say, okay, it's a need, okay? And like I said, you'll feel better when you do it anyway. And if you don't, then try and figure out why, you know, y'all aren't connecting in that way. And what, because sometimes you are harboring feelings about other things, and those things will weigh heavy on you. And so when you go to do what you do with your mate or your spouse, I'm saying, when you go to do those things and you have those things in your mind, being a woman, it's hard to connect. It really is. You know, your mind needs to be focused on what's going on at that time, not thinking about what he did last week or what he did 2 years ago. You got to forgive, and then you have to actively be involved with one another every day. I'm not saying have sex every day, unless you just want to, but yeah, y'all decide on how frequently you think y'all should be interacting, but you need to sit down and have that conversation, because those needs need to be met. Okay. Yeah. That's it for today. I love you guys. Do what you do best. And that's being you. Okay. Happy holidays.